The retrial of Bruce Lehrmann, the man accused of raping Brittany Higgins, is expected to be abandoned and charges against him dropped today. 10 News First Chloe Boris joins us from Canberra. Good morning to you, Chloe. The lead prosecutor is expected to make an announcement sometime this morning.
Good morning. Yes, in 2 hours, the Director of Public Prosecution, Shane Drumgold, will make an address to media about the future of Bruce Lehrmann's retrial. Now, it'll be a short, pre-prepared statement and he won't be taking any questions. But it is expected, based on newspaper reports this morning, that the case will not go ahead. News.com.au is reporting that, quote, new medical evidence detailing the impact of a second trial on Brittany Higgins' mental health is expected to result in the charge being dropped and the trial not proceeding. If that were to happen, Mr. Lehrmann, who has consistently maintained his innocence, will no longer be prosecuted over the allegations. The former Liberal staffer is accused of raping his then colleague in Parliament House in March 2019. Mr. Lehrmann pleaded not guilty to a charge of sexual intercourse without consent. The first trial was aborted because of juror misconduct, a second trial scheduled for early next year.
Thank you for the update, Chloe, and we will have all of the latest details that come in live at 10 a.m. this morning. It is judgment day for convicted wife killer Chris Dawson. Almost 40 years after murdering Lynette Dawson and disposing of her body, the former Sydney school teacher will be sentenced today. The New South Wales Supreme Court will consider his lack of remorse, his deteriorating health, and relentless media coverage for the jail term. The 74-year-old has been in custody since the guilty verdict in August. Lynette vanished from Sydney's northern beaches in January 1982. And her body has never been found. The controversial industrial relations bill is on the verge of becoming law, which would mean wage growth across multiple sectors. The bill, which is the biggest workplace law changes in two decades, has passed the Senate. It'll go to the House of Representatives this morning and likely get final approval. The legislation took months of negotiations with independent Senator David Pocock and an 11th-hour coalition debate to get past the finishing line. There's a crippling cost of living crunch forecast for Victorians. Household gas bills are set to soar by $500 next year. It applies to basic no-frills contracts with residents to endure a price hike between 16 to 38%. Small businesses are also in for bill pain, with an incredible 68% increase predicted. Almost 200,000 homes are on these contracts, which are effectively a default deal. Three men are on the run in Melbourne after dressing in hazmat suits, arming themselves with crowbars and smashing through a jewellery store. The brazen heist unfolded yesterday morning in Deer Park and was over in less than a minute. It was all captured on camera by shocked shoppers, mainly families, doing their Christmas shopping. Police say the group fled the scene in a stolen white Golf sedan. Tragically, a pregnant mum and her unborn baby have died after an unprovoked attack with a block of concrete in a Perth car park. Diane Miller went into cardiac arrest after a rock was thrown through her car window and struck her in the head at a shopping centre on Tuesday. The 30-year-old, who also had an 8-month-old son, was declared brain dead. Her brother says the family has been left destroyed. Western Australia police have opened a homicide investigation. A teenager had previously been charged with causing grievous bodily harm. A man has been charged with the murder of a woman in Melbourne's Inner North. A 51-year-old woman was found dead in a garage at a Northcote property on Wednesday night. Police combed the site for clues, describing the death as suspicious. Hours later, a 52-year-old man was arrested and charged. It's believed the pair are known to each other. A former suspect in the disappearance of William Tyrrell has been awarded a massive payout after suing the state for malicious prosecution over historical allegations, which he's now been cleared of. The state's police force has been ordered to pay Bill Spedding almost $1.5 million, but once court costs are applied, that figure could easily swell to more than $2 million.
Bill Spedding has fought long and hard for this moment, successfully suing the state for malicious prosecution.
I was prosecuted for crimes I did not commit, all in the hope that my prosecution would further the police investigation of me as a suspect in the disappearance of William Tyrrell.
Awarded almost $1.5 million in damages plus court costs, the 71-year-old says it can't make up for what has been lost.
No sum of money will restore the life I enjoyed before this terrible nightmare.
With Spedding once a suspect in the missing boy's disappearance, a judge has rejected former lead detective Gary Jubelin's claim he doesn't know who tipped off the media when the grandfather was arrested in 2015, spending 58 days behind bars over unrelated historical child sexual assault allegations which were disproven, and seeing copious amounts of death threats directed at him. It was an arrest described as frenetic and poorly conceived, and which could never, in my view, have been justified and was clearly malicious.
My reputation was severely and permanently damaged. My family life was torn apart.
This was an example of poor police work and this very, very serious damage that it does.
Mr. Spedding remains traumatised to this day, the judge found, saying that the public perception of him as the prime suspect in William Tyrrell's disappearance was directly engineered by the police strike force on the case.
New South Wales Police says it is reviewing the court's decision. Alice Hogg for 10 News First.
A water main has burst in Sydney's CBD overnight, sending water shooting into the middle of the road and nearby shops. Fire and rescue crews were called to Market Street in the early hours of this morning. The street turned into a massive fountain, flooding a nearby Westfield and car park. Fortunately, they did manage to turn off the water and clear the street before busy peak hour rush this morning. Well, come Sunday, Australia and Argentina will be arch nemesises in the World Cup. But right now, they're joining forces because both teams are taking a swipe at the FIFA scheduling, suggesting the three-day turnaround is too short for players to recover. The time difference between games will only shorten should the Socceroos make it into the quarterfinals.
It's something that FIFA need to consider, that we're not robots, that we are humans and that we do need to recover and that we can't, you know, we can't just play day after day, you know, we need a break as well.
The Socceroos defender also dubbed the Argentinian captain, Lionel Messi, one of the greatest of all time, fairly said, but says the Aussies won't directly target him. Batsman Steve Smith is still confident Australia can win the first test against the West Indies, and that's despite only four wickets falling across the 2 days. On day one, both Smith and Manus Labuschagne scored a massive double century with a 99-run effort by Travis Head, allowing the Aussies to declare 4 for 598. But two not outs from West Indies captain Craig Braithwaite, scoring 18 off 79 balls and another 47 runs off 73, by Tarjanreena Chandapal, is making the Aussies sweat. The West Indies will continue to chase this afternoon at Optus Stadium.